solo there, Geoff Carter, eh? And it's 7 a.m. in the morning, and I'm a bit bog-eyed because I had a couple of drinks yesterday with my friends. And why not? I'm on my holidays. Anyway, I've been awake since about 4:30, and I thought I'd just have a little stroll, a bit of a mooch down Soi Buakhao, and just have a little look, because I walked down here the other morning and there was loads of monks and things collecting food. I thought it'd be nice to make a video on it. Anyway, people are saying, oh, it's expensive now, Thailand. Well, I've just come back from the Philippines, and it's not much difference in money. I'll tell you, by the time you pay for more expensive hotels and things, and when I've come here, it's very much the same as last year, so don't be worrying about the money. And there's promotions on in different bars, like my mate Marcus. He's got a bar there on the plaza down there, 49 baht for a drink. That's cheap enough. And here, the original marquee bar, these are doing special offers on dinners. Today is Friday, and they're doing 100 baht for fish and chips. Sunday roast, only 100 baht. Pork and steak, every day, only 100 baht. So it's not expensive. And then I've been to the chicken and sweet corn soup lady. I had crispy chicken yesterday and rice. Hello. And soup, and it was only 90 baht. So it's not expensive. All these bars are still here. They're all right, ticking over. And then you've got all your normal ones what are here. But on the corner, there's a new one just opened. It used to be 7-Eleven, and now it's called Amazon Beer Bar. Passed that the other night, that was okay. So there we go. And now we're coming up to the Archon. Archon Bar 1 and Archon Bar 2. They're all right, they're cheap drinks in there. And they're open 24 hours a day. So let's say you fly in at, say, 4 o'clock in the morning and you can't check in your hotel or anything like that. Just go in here and sit down and have a few drinks and that until you can check in. Morning. Right, so let's carry on and see what we can see on Geoff Carter's mooch about. Because we love mooching, don't we? What I'll do, I'll just film stuff what I see, and then at least you can see it as I'm seeing it, as I say. Okay, Archon 1 and 2 coming up. See, these people sat here now at 7 o'clock in the morning. But most of them are drinking tea and orange juice and having a little breakfast. There we go. And this place here, Pig and Chick, this is now like a local butcher's. So if you've got like your own apartment with a kitchen and all that, and you don't want to go out every night, you can buy your meat here very, very cheap. And they do eggs as well and stuff like that. So there you have it. And you can cook your own food, can't you? So dead, dead easy. Exchange rates at the moment hovering around 40 baht to the English pound. But I'll just show you there for everybody else who's watching from different countries. So there's the rates at the moment. And then we'll go across this side here. There you go. There's your rates for today. But I think they open at 10 a.m. So them rates were yesterday's. They could go up or down. Now here's where all the people do all the food for the people going to work. There you go, you see. And this is just people getting on with their lives. Selling fresh produce. Selling rice porridge over there. And then you've got the crispy bananas and things over there. And then you've got these people delivering. Deliver. Don't worry about the ice over here. You know, like when you go Spain and places like that, you go, ooh, that ice. I had ice in my Bacardi last night and it knocked me for six. Well, these are all proper big bagged pure water ice. And then these ladies here now serving all this, and it's all in like takeaway bags ready for the day. Look, lovely. Yeah. And here's one of the monks now, blessing one of the shopkeepers. He's doing a little prayer and give like a little donation. Then here's all the fresh produce market with all your vegetables, all your garlic, your gingers and everything. And then all your mangoes and grapes. So it's great if you've got a little apartment with a little kitchen and that and a fridge. You get all that stock in and it's dirt cheap. Here's some more ladies now buying some street food. Yeah, look at that. That looks fantastic. Look at that. Beautiful. Aroi?
Aroi.
Oh, yeah. Yum, yum.
Chim.
Yeah, fantastic. Right, so all this is the same here. But let me show you this here now. There's a little cut through here. This is Tesco Express. And if you go through there, there's loads of little bars down there at night. Okay, so that's okay, innit? And then here now, you've got Trench Town. Live reggae music every night. These do special offers on drinks. And so does Jolly's over there with the P-I-S-S stop. You know I don't swear. All day happy hour. Just 60 back. That and the Samsung is only 50. That's the like the Thai whiskey and Coca-Cola, so that's all right, isn't it? So nothing's really changed on this little bit. They put a new sign up here at the Crazy 80 bar, so I presume that's under new management. Excuse me, Arsenal. But basically we're just looking round now and just seeing what's going on. It's people just getting on with the day, really. This is a new one, I think. At all, coffee and beer bar. That looks nice. And then here, right, I shouldn't really tell you because it's hard to get a seat in here anyway, but I am going to share it with you. Right, as you come to here now, you see the TT currency exchange there, and there, once that shutters up there, they are the best spare ribs in town. And you can get a small portion for 90 baht, medium 150 and large 220 baht. And the ribs are to die for. And they come with like a salad and chips and all that caper. And that is really, really good, that. Now we're changing. This is the start here now of Tree Town. And they've been building it for years. And it's all up and coming now. This is where the people are coming at night now. It's really good. And here's Chunky Monkey if you want some English or Thai food. Quite cheap. That's good. And then you got the Dragon Bar here. This is a nice little beer bar. And in the day, obviously the bar's not open, so the people just set up and do cooking and things. But look at this here. What's that? Have that then. Right, all right, love, are you okay?
Good morning
darling, are you okay?
You okay?
Same. Yes, fantastic. Everybody's dead happy, dead friendly. Nothing's changed much along here now, so we're just having a little walk. You've got a new club there, Tanya Club. I haven't got a clue, but this is the start of Tree Town, and when it's all lit up at night it looks fantastic. You can sit up there and listen to the music. I'll just quickly walk you over there in a minute. There's some gentlemen here now. Morning. Right, let's just nip over here quick. So there's about 20 or 30 bars over here. And they're not expensive, but loads of little food outlets, look. So you can just sit here and chill out with a nice beer. And it's all undercover just in case it rains. And then there's some really nice bars down there as well. So this is called Tree Town. I think really it's the new walking street. It's just getting developed now because walking street's finished for me. You only get, you don't get many. You get like Indians, Chinese and Russians all going down there. All just looking, they don't really spend in the bars. Here's a new one, not seen this before. Cares Bar, party bar, look. That used to be the pub bar, that, with all the Ladyboys. And then here's the new Hungry Hippo. Yeah, they do all cheap foods. Bangers and Mash, 99. Amex Chips, 139. And there's the world famous Scooters. That's one of my favourite pubs there. That's all up and running at night now. Resort-wise, it's still quiet, and I've been speaking to some of the bar owners, and they've seen a drop in the people. But it's all this scaremongering saying, oh, Thailand's gone expensive. I've been here now 5 or 6 days, and I swear to you now, I don't think it's any more expensive than it was last Christmas. So don't be scared of coming just for the money, because that Philippines, it's a nice place, but it's not as cheap as what they say. Coyote Hustle Bar there. And then on this corner here was just like a little cafe, and they had like a Filipino band on. But now it's turned into a rock bar. So, aye aye. It's turned into a rock bar at night, that. So there's a lot going on there as well. So that's a good one. And that'll cut down there. That cuts you down to the triangle bar on Soi Chai Poon. So, crawl in. Hey, chickens everywhere. Yes, beer bar, I've not seen that one before. Annie Jack's, Fantasy Lounge, that's normally full of ladyboys, if that's what you like. Chicken Tikka restaurant, I recommend that. If you're into Indian food, that's a good place that to go. And that is just opposite here, Soi Oni. And Soi Oni there is where you've got lots of little bars and lots of massage parlours. So if you want a massage, there it is, just down there, Soi Oni. And then we're coming up now to LK Metro. Hello, you all right? You all right? You okay? What's your name?
My name is May.
Hey, you're very nice. See you later.
You okay?
Yeah, bye-bye. That's May. Is it though? Right, okay. 7-Elevens, and then where we did the big thing here, come play with me, we did a big video there for them. And here is the LK Metro. It's getting quite busy down the bottom end there at night now. Was in the Cafe Racer Bar and Billabong and that the other night, and that was quite busy actually. But the drinks are only like 60 baht on average, so you're not really going over the top there. And it's like I've said to people, even if you think it's expensive, what you need to do is have two beers less on the night, and it all works out the same anyway. So, and this is the tin cup where I normally go. This is belting noodle soup in here and that, but they've blocked it all off for some reason. So, good in there. Really nice cheap food in there. It's called the tin cup. And here's two lads here now collecting. Morning, boys. So what I found down here the other day, there was about 20 or 30 monks. Must be from the normal, from like the local place. And they come and collect the food for the day. But what I've noticed is they're all walking barefoot. I don't know how they do it. They must get accustomed to like the hard floor. But I couldn't walk along here. There's loads of like little stones and things. Anyway, Soi Chai Poon we're on now, right? Soi Chai Poon. And it used to be called Soi Pothole. But not anymore. They've done it all up. They put a brand new road in. Oh, I can't show you that because let me just get out the sun. There. Just down there. There you go. Oh, so now I reckon it's probably about 20 past seven. And it's getting warm already. People here now just washing the front down ready there. But this junction here is going to be the maddest junction in Pattaya. You want to see this at 12 o'clock in the afternoon. Absolute carnage. Just watch it now, watch. This is 20 past 7 in the morning, by the way. See what I mean? Everybody just jumping in, diving around. Right, this down here now is Soi Lenki, down here. And that is where I got my motorbike from, right? But right down the bottom of there, for all you who are regulars in Pattaya, right down the bottom end, 98 baht or 99 baht, whatever it was, full English breakfast, orange juice, coffee or tea at the Retox Bar. So I woke up the other morning and I thought, right, went for a full English breakfast. Got down there, it's gone. the retox, it's no longer down there. So if you're gonna have a walk down there, I've saved you a walk now, am I? Go down there, it's gone. The frontage is gone, it's back to two hotels and a little porter cabin. So that's what's happening down there. Not a lot now. I don't know what's happened to it, but it's just gone overnight. Girls here now buying all the... Let's just have a look what they're buying here. Fish, eggs, chilies, coriander, stuff like that. And basically it's food for the day, because I don't know about you, but I have, like, say, my breakfast, my dinner and my tea. The Thais have five meals or six meals a day, and they reckon it's more healthy for you. I mean, look at them now. This is like 20 past seven in the morning. Everybody just, wow, rice soup. Wow. So within 20 minutes now, this soya has gone absolutely chock-a-block. Unbelievable. And then here's 18 coins. Apparently that's a nice place to stay, quite cheap. And if you want to know where Sutras Court is, it's just here in front. As you can see, it's all street food. Local dustbin men here. These lads put the work in. I've been watching them. And then just coming up here now, I'm going to call it a day, but I need to just show you down here, because this is where Kevin Thailand, my mate Kevin Thailand, had his parties here at the Hideaway with Andy, just down here on Soi 15, so at least you know what part of the Soi Buakhao it is down here. And Andy has the Elton John tribute band on and stuff like that, and he has Killer Pool, so that's worth looking for. Like, Google it, the Hideaway. So that's it really down here. And today it will be the Soi Buakhao market, with it being Friday. Katsuri there, or the Katsuri, however you want to pronounce it. That's a nice little hotel. And then this little cut through here. I've not seen this before, I'll just show you now. This is a little cut through before Soi 15, so it goes through and then round. But this has got some nice little bars in. There. I'll show you, I'll cut through here rather than go on the end. Golden Times. That looks like it's a gentleman's club there. You've got a lovely bar here, what does excellent food. And then a couple of little guest houses. And then Baku Lounge. The beer garden corner. So, some nice little things if you want to come out of the way, if you don't want to be on that main road. And round here, I went here last year, I read about it. Right in the corner there, Pizza Italy, right? And they cook them fresh, and I tell you what, that's one of the best pizzas I've had in Pattaya. So there we have it really. I haven't got a clue what this is. It says the Naughty Club. So I reckon if you go in there, it's gonna be naughty. Right, so we're going round here now, back onto Soi 15. And Andy actually has rooms here what you can stay in. And we're coming up now to the Hideaway. And they do lots of nice food in here as well. And if they have a party night, it's free food. Open from 9 till 1. Every day, cold beers, bar game, free pool. That's good round here, free pool. Because now they started charging you 20 baht a game. So that's a good one. But the only reason I'm coming here now before I finish, I'm going to tell you where I've been going for breakfast. It's not the cheapest place in the world, but it's a great place. It's 299 baht for a buffet breakfast. And you get all kinds of food from all over the world. I'll just show it you now. And there's just one special thing about it. You sit down at your table and the view is to die for. I'll just show you now. Oh, I'm getting fair jiggered. That heat's coming up now. It's a good job I started filming this early. Right, so here we go. The Sentara. It's called the Sentara, okay? And I'll just quickly show you why we love it here. Wow. We sit here at this table and look at all this. You can just look at all these beautiful fish in the fish tank. And it's all air conditioned, right? So here is the egg station. They do the omelets, the poached egg, the fried egg, and then you've got the soup over there. And so you can have your noodle soup. Here's all the ingredients you can put in yourself. There's your noodles and that. Okay, I'll walk around this tank because all the way around there's different things to see. Wow, okay. So over there in the corner there, you've got tea, coffee, and then you've got all your espressos and things. And then you don't need me to lift all these up. Everybody does it. You've got all the different foods, and you've got all your fresh bacon there cooking on the grill, look. There we go. And you can have some Thai food as well. So we've got the soups there and all the bits what you put in, like the fried onions and that, and then some more soup. And then we've got the dreaded toast machine. The one that you have to put your toast through two or three times, and when it comes through on the last time, it's burnt. And then we got the buns, all the different types of bread, the croissants, the donuts, the cakes, and the chocolate ones, fantastic. And then we got the jams and cheese and ham, and then we got all the salad there, all the salad bowls, and then we've got all the yogurts and the muesli and the pineapple and the mixed fruits there. All your ice water, your milk. You've also got all your different fruit juices. You've got all fresh fruit here, and you've got all your cereals. You've got your oranges, your apples, and your bananas. And that gentleman there, hello. Good morning. How are you doing?
I'm great. Glenn.
You're looking great. Are you enjoying the breakfast?
Oh, enjoying the breakfast. And everybody subscribe to your channel. He's the best.
We never planned that one, did we? See you later, my friend. Okay, so 299 baht. I think it's a bargain. You know, treat yourself and just come and sit down there and watch the fish. Right, the sun's coming up now, so I'll just stay here before I say goodbye. For all you people who are just about to fly out to Thailand, if you're coming to Pattaya, etc., etc., have a safe journey. Don't be worried what they're all saying, oh, it's expensive. There's loads of bars where you can get drinks from like 45, 49, 50 baht, and there's really cheap places to eat. So come and enjoy yourselves. Come back to Thailand, everybody, because Thailand is my land.